Hi there, my name is Yu, and I'm an UTAU user who goes by the username of Yunari. I've been an UTAU user for over 3 years now, so I figured it would be nice if I made some tutorials for people who are relatively new to the UTAU community. Seeing how most UTAU tutorials out there right now are rather outdated. So I hope I'll be able to teach you guys something, and yeah, I hope you enjoy. In this tutorial, I'll be going over the basics of UTAU as well as the interface of the software. If you haven't installed UTAU yet, I highly recommend you go watch this video here first. Now, before I delve into the interface part of this tutorial, I first want to discuss some very important words that are commonly used within the UTAU community. The first one being voicebank. A voicebank is pretty much a folder which contains all the recorded syllables of an UTAU. UTAUs will use these audio files when you're working within the UTAU program. So it's basically just a database compiled of audio files. And the other word you really need to know is UST. A UST file is pretty much just an UTAU project file. Online you'll be able to find a lot of USTs that are made specifically to cover certain songs. Alright, so now that we have that out of the way, let's get started. Alright, so when you first open up UTAU, you'll get a screen like this. It might look a bit intimidating at first, but don't worry, it's really not that hard to use. As you can see, in the top left corner over here, we have a little icon. This icon lets you know which UTAU you're currently using. If we click on this icon, we'll get a little pop-up box. The current UTAU we're using is Defoco. Defoco is the default UTAU that comes standard with the UTAU program. Within this box, we'll be able to see various properties of her voice bank, such as the amount of files that are present within her voice bank, the size of her voice bank, average frequency, her vocal range, all that good stuff. Aside from that, there's also a little sample button. When we click on this button, we'll be able to hear several vocal samples from her voice bank. On the bottom, we'll be able to see a little description regarding Defoco. This usually includes copyright policies, general information regarding the voice bank, personal information regarding the UTAU, and extra stuff you might have to know in order to use the voice bank properly. Alright, so let's go over the top bar first. First, we have tempo. The tempo indicates how fast UTAU is supposed to play through the notes you lay out within UTAU. A high tempo number, for example, will result in UTAU playing rather quickly through notes, while a low tempo number will result in UTAU playing through the notes rather slowly. Tempo is always defined in beats per minute. Beats per minute being the amount of taps you can play within a minute. So a BPM of 120, for example, would be 2 taps per second. Next we have quantize. Quantize indicates the minimal note length a note should have within the UTAU program. The smallest being 1/64th of a note. For beginners, I highly recommend to not change this number. And to be honest, the same can be said for length. I wouldn't mess with this setting either. Next up, we have these two buttons. In UTAU, you can switch between your mouse and your pencil. If we grab the pencil, you can see you can draw notes with it. This can be either long notes or short notes, and they'll always be automatically connected. Then we have the zoom in and the zoom out button. Doesn't need much explaining, I suppose. These two buttons allow you to skip to the start of your project file or the end of your project file. The other two buttons right here do pretty much the same, except these skip to the first and last note of your project file. As for these three buttons, make sure you have mode 2 enabled, so just click on the first button and make sure it says mode 2. Seeing how it's a lot easier to use UTAU within mode 2 than it is within mode 1. Don't ask me why, just be sure to change it. As for the trace and render button, I personally never use them, so I don't really know what they do. Next we have the lyrics box alongside with these three buttons. If we type in some syllables within this lyrics box, select the notes and press the little white button here, the default lyrics will be replaced with the text we just typed. If we instead press the pink button, our lyrics will be inserted after the notes we drew within newly made notes. And last we have the R button. The R stands for rest, meaning these are notes that are meant to be silent. And next to these we finally have the most important buttons within the entire UTAU program. The play, pause and stop button. So we have our lyrics inserted into our notes. The most logical thing would be to just select them and press play. That's weird. No sound. Don't worry, there's not an error within the program. This is what's supposed to happen. The reason why she's silent is because Defoko is a Japanese UTAU, and thus won't be able to recognize the Roman alphabet. If we want to make her sing these lyrics, we'll first have to convert them to Japanese. In this case, hiragana. Now let's play them again. Yay, we made her sing! Oh, and before you freak out for not having the option within your menu that I just used, that's supposed to be like that. If you wish to know how I got that option there, be sure to watch my plugins tutorial. Now we also have these few MIDI buttons right here. Again, I never use these, so I have no clue what they do, so I'm gonna skip these. And these last five buttons are very important when you're busy making an UTAU cover. If you want to know why they're so important and how you should use them, be sure to check out this tutorial. But be sure to finish watching this tutorial first, okay? Aside from those, we also have a few buttons down here. The button you should have enabled is the squiggly line one. This one will allow you to see pitch bends between the notes. Pitch bends being these little red lines you see between the notes. Oh yeah, and all the way over here we also have a little box. Currently mine says M, the M basically standing for multi-select or something like that. This means that when you select a bunch of notes, like this, and you drag them around, all of them will be dragged around. While if I shut this off, I select them and I try to drag them around, only the note I have pinpointed will be dragged around. I know it's kind of weird that they didn't make this a standard thing, but yeah, the more you know. And finally we have the most top row. The top row that's present in pretty much any software. First we have File. File allows you to make a new project, open an already existing project, save a project, save as, append. Append allows you to mend two projects together, like merge them together. Meaning, if you click on append, the notes from one project will be important to the project you're currently working on. Like this. As for import and export, you mainly use those if you wish to use UTAU together with the Vocaloid software, but I'm not gonna go into detail regarding that, so sorry. And recent shows you the files you've currently been working on. Next up we have edit. Edit allows you to cut, copy, paste and delete notes. Select all notes. Select notes by name. Insert a rest, but again you can just use the button for this. Then we have move region up and move region down, which is the same thing as dragging a bunch of notes around. Move region by number is an option I often use, and I'll be explaining why in the UTAU cover tutorial. Other than that, we have merge notes, quantize, remove rests, region and region property. Oh, and by the way, if you right click on a note, you'll get a little pop-up list which shows both cut, copy, paste, delete, and all those other edit options you just saw in the edit menu. So I recommend just using this drop-down list instead of the edit function, but that's just my preference. We also have view. I don't really use these options, so next. search, which allows you to search for certain notes, I think. Again, I don't use this ever, so I don't know what each of these options do. And now we come to the most important tab, which is the project tab. The first option allows you to render the WAV file, meaning this option allows you to export the vocals you've just created within UTAU. Then we have play rendered file, which does the exact same thing as the play, pause and stop button. And we have project property. Project property is quite noteworthy, so I'll also be explaining this window right here for a bit. Project name is the name of your project. Output file name is the name of the rendered WAV file. Then we have Voicebank. When we click on the second bar, a list will pop up, or at least on mine. These are all the Voicebank you currently have installed within UTAU. Again, because you're probably a newcomer to UTAU, the only UTAU you currently have is Defoco, but if you wish to know how to download other UTAUs beside her, I recommend you go watch this video after having finished watching this one. And we also have rendering options, which is another thing I'll save for a different tutorial. Alright, so when we close out of that, we also have play. Play does the same as the buttons. We also have tools. Tools is really important when you're busy making your own voice bank, as well as when you're working with plugins. But again, I'll save that for a different tutorial. And last but not least, we have help. Here you'll be able to see what version of UTAU you're using, as well as enter a registration key, if you have one. Well, that's pretty much it regarding the basics of UTAU. I hope you enjoyed and I hope you learned something from this tutorial. In the next tutorial, I'll be going over what Voicebank and what UST types there are. So I highly recommend you go check out that tutorial. Thanks for watching. Bye!